Hello, my friends, and welcome back to Storm Over Europe. It's episode 5. Just quickly. Go ahead and dumpster this. Artillery, it's probably not the wisest move to be stuck in the mountains like this, but hey. Pressure up. It's not the road either, so you can't move. Yep, that's fine. I didn't put this next to him because I just figured it would be too dangerous, but the more I look at it, the more I actually have choices. But anyway, whatever. It's fine. Let's go ahead. Oh, I lowballed and they survived. Gross. For 5, the old recon cars, man, they're just not quite spicy enough. Well, it's all infantry, so I might as well just use this. Okay, I got him. Oh yeah, it's a port, isn't it? So. Like, I got him in an encirclement. Aha, ruined. I actually have to put a unit here to block the port. Why are they not blocked? Bit weird. Okay, they can't get out anyway. They can't get out, they're pinned. It's only a matter of time. A little bit risky here because, you know, I'm actually leaving my units undefended from air, but I don't think they've got much air left. I think the air is dead. This is where it turns out that I'm wrong and I get bombed for the next week, but I think the air force is dead. This is the only airport left that they have anyway. Also a little one down in the I just figure I might as well come across here, right? One more to get there, and then the next one, and I'm back on the road. Is like, hey, nails, man, cool. The man, the myth, the legend. Oh, I can shred them with this. To be fair, 5 soft attack is not, you know, it's not terrible. Especially with another plus 1. I mean, it's not great either. Alright, it's clear. Boom. Right, there's no airport, so let's do a flyby. Just looks like some militia. So I think we're effectively clear to just drive these units straight towards where they need to be. Could have been infantry in the hills, actually. That, in a way, that was a boneheaded move, but... Now, I'm gonna rebase this to scout the rest. Pure cheese, I love it. I think this area is clear. I think it would be wise to cut right here and just clear this. I knew up to here was clear because I saw it earlier with the super scout car, but I wasn't sure about this bit, this little chunk here, so in case that looked really risky, it actually wasn't. Alright, let's clean this little pocket of garbage out. There's quite a lot of infantry and anti-tank guns, but we got most of the area secure. Like, up to this river is basically secure. Just need to take out these few little bits and pieces, or the shredder will probably eat its way through that in seconds. Shame this is a railway, that would have been the ideal place to actually go down, but 12 turns left. I'm not too nervous about the time. I'm concerned about yellow getting stuck on this river, though. A little bit of clearance going on here. It's actually pretty reasonable. Finish off that artillery, go down there and take that town. That would be ideal. I gotta get rid of them because I don't want them to take my airport, that's all. I'll clear them away next turn. I mean, it's just militia, it's really not a problem. Aircraft gun's gonna get hurt. A lot. Okay, tanks. Tanks rolling forward. But on the bright side, if they move, their entrenchment will be destroyed. Although I think the shredder wouldn't care, but the destruction of the entrenchment obviously means we can just more expediently clean the area. I think the AI is set to be defensive on this mission, so preferring instead to preserve its entrenchment. Thinking that its entrenchment will save it. glorious provocateur hole. By putting this here, which encourages them to attack it. Cannot even be bothered to change these to anti-air mode. Let's just murder the unit in question. Okay, we got just a wall of infantry and stuff, but only 10 turns left. Slowed down. Send this recon car this way to go and help with this infantry that's just kind of floating around everywhere. That tank is maybe not even going to make it to the front lines. It's slowed down so much. It's not a particularly fast vehicle in the first place. Okay, the shredder is in. Turd, what a shit. And now look what has happened to you. 1 HP. I don't know if I can get down here and save this tank. He's put himself in a predicament, to say the least. Busting forward. pen this. They can't pen this, but they might attack this because they think they can pen it. So this is actually another useful provocateur situation. Breaking the corner slowly. Still alive because this repaired and this didn't attack, I guess. Yes, trying to rescue this tank is not going to be easy. Some of it's secured, some of it's not secured. Okay. Themselves, and that's what I want. Okay, got him in a pin. Tank can hold out for one more turn, I will be able to actually save it. It will be a miracle though. It truly will be a miracle. going hard on the enemy. That's probably why. Ouch. Dependable support. Double your prizes! Okay, that's no longer able to offer any meaningful help. Would you believe it? I rescued that tank. Now all Yellow has to do is repair it. That poor infantry has like all these guns pointed at it from every single conceivable angle. As well as being encircled. That cannot feel good. Shaping up. Okay, let's go ahead and shred this. Maybe shred this too. Shame to like yellow massive actually set it up, but hey, saga. Left to say or do here, it's really just a matter of cleaning up now. Looks like my strategy worked. I mean, there was time to go follow the major road all the way around. I mean, it's amazing how fast you can move when you've got a major road. Your shredder tank just turns the infantry blobs into barely an inconvenience. Without picking up those butcher heroes, it would never have worked. So, hey. This should be over this turn. Yellow should finish the job here. All they gotta do is push this guy out and take the top. Except Yes. Weird decision making. Super weird decision making. General, we finally did it! This war is over, and in no small part due to your magnificent leadership. Received a case of fine Italian wine from General Berti, along with a note. General, it's been an honor to fight alongside you this long journey to victory. I've been ordered to remain in Spain to train nationalist forces, but now be to congratulate you on finally bringing this war to a conclusion. May your home give you well-deserved welcome as a hero. We've found out that both Generals Valeria and Franco are on their way to your headquarters. In fact, they should be arriving any minute. My authority as the Commander-in-Chief in Spanish Military Forces bestow you the Royal and Military Order of St. Ferdinand. Wear it with pride. For it is not often that such a medal is awarded to anyone other than the loyal sons of Spain. The Spanish Civil War is now over. Condor Legion is being recalled to Germany. Your core forces will be safe for the next campaign. Storm over Europe has only just begun. And it will continue when you guys vote for it on the Patreon. So, I must say, there's a couple of major things. And I'm not talking about the spelling mistakes, okay, and grammatical errors and such. Would be nice if someone went through and proofread and fixed all that, but anyway. The two issues are that, and really the first issue is more to do with the game than anything else, is that heroes are probably one of the most interesting aspects of the game, but their randomness in terms of their power means that this mod could be extremely difficult or very easy depending on which heroes you get, because all the units have got like homogeneous stats, so it's not like, you know, infantry get ruined in the open, they're just less effective there. It's not like recon cars get ruined by tanks, they're just less effective. Like, every unit only has a moderate advantage over the over what it's supposed to counter, is what I want to say. So, without, because of this, without, say, if I didn't have Butcher and Ignore's Entrenchment, it would have been so much more difficult for me to, remove enemy infantry from cities and towns. You know, I can just imagine that without any good tools for that purpose, you'd have a real struggle. And likewise, the fact that I got the surrender combo means that a lot of tank traps and stuff were just easily destroyed. And I think scenario designers have got a real problem in that they cannot account for the balance of heroes that well. So I feel like what they should do is they should make mods where they say in the briefing to turn off heroes in the advanced options, and then actually provide heroes to the player, so that then they know what heroes the player has got, ignoring the killer team, of course. And that way they can get the balance that much tighter and neater. And then the other thing, of course, is why have... I know it's thematic, but why have the AI controlled factions. It's just awful to play with them. It's just, watching them play badly hurts my soul. Even when they're not busy getting in the way and doing absolutely boneheaded stuff. It's just frustrating. It's not fun at all, in my opinion. Just give me control of all the units, okay? Please.
Please.
I don't want to play a game where I then hand over the game, half of the army, to a 5-year-old and let them play. I mean, actually, I would be totally okay with letting a 5-year-old have a go just because they're 5 years old and I want them to experience the joy of gaming. But there's no such joy that comes from letting an AI with the mind of a 5-year-old play, okay? It's just agony. And there's a reason why, after the official Spanish Civil War, we never did the AI-controlled factions thing again, or hardly ever, because it's just painful, it's frustrating. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed Storm Over Europe. It's been a long road, and I'm glad that you guys have walked it with me. And I will, of course, as always, see you in the next campaign.